Citroen C3 review. Our rating: 4 star. The Citroen C3 isn't the best super mini to drive, but it makes up for this with personalization and efficient engines. 4. Low running costs, generous boot, scope for personalization. Against: steering doesn't communicate well, body lean in corners, engines noisy if worked hard. The Citroen C3 is the French manufacturer's offering in one of the most hotly contested areas of the car market, super minis. So it's going up against the likes of the Ford Fiesta, Vauxhall Corsa, and Volkswagen Polo. In truth, though, the Citroen doesn't really try to take on any of those three established names in their respective areas of strength. It doesn't claim to handle as sweetly as the Fiesta, or be as refined and well-finished as the Polo. Citroen's trying to move away from heavy discounts, too, so it probably won't be as cheap to buy as a Corsa. Instead, Citroen has tried to embody one of its core brand values with the C3, comfort. That's not to say it has some flash, expensive suspension setup. Indeed, look below the funky exterior and you'll find lots of the same mechanicals that underpin the previous generation of the car, but the engineers have tried to dial in as much bump absorption as possible, and worked on elements like rolling refinement to make the car a relaxed place to be when it's on the move. In lots of ways they've succeeded, which means that the C3 does indeed merit consideration by anyone who's in the market for a car of this size. The engine lineup comprises three versions of Citroën's 1.2-liter three-cylinder petrol motor, with 67 bhp, 81 bhp and 109 bhp, and a 1.6-liter diesel, badged Blue Envy, and offered with either 74 bhp or 99 bhp. The standard gearbox throughout is a 5-speed manual, but a 6-speed automatic will also be available with some engines. We've tried the two more powerful engines and it's already safe to say that these will be the pick of the lineup. The 67 bhp unit is likely to feel pretty wheezy, although it will, of course, be the cheapest way to get into a C3. Our choice: Citroen C3 Feel Pure Tech 82 manual. The Citroen C3 is a name that seems to have been around forever in the super mini market, although in fact, this is only the third car to carry the badge. The original C3 was launched back in 2002 as the indirect replacement for the Saxo. Citroen elected to split its small car offering between the 5-door C3 and the 3-door C2. It dropped the second of those models around the same time as the second-gen C3 appeared, in 2009, and the latest third generation is being offered as a 5-door only, too. As with both of the earlier generations, this C3 sits on a modified version of the PSA Peugeot Citroën Group's PF1 chassis components. You can trace this set of parts as far back as the Peugeot 206 from 1999, although in truth they've evolved beyond recognition since their debut. Its latest incarnation has modifications to improve its performance in pedestrian impact tests, and to boost its protection for the car's occupants in side impacts. Citroën has worked hard to trim weight elsewhere in the chassis and ensure that the overall weight of the C3 remains about the same as the car that preceded it. The rest of the mechanical lineup looks pretty familiar, with a mixture of PureTech 3-cylinder petrol engines and Blue Envy 4-cylinder diesels in the range. All of these motors get a 5-speed manual gearbox as standard, although Citroën is also offering a 6-speed automatic on the higher-powered engines. It's a proper auto, too. The company has finally admitted defeat and dropped the jerky automated manual that it offered on the previous C3. The range is split into three trim levels. The cheapest version, Touch, does without air conditioning or alloy wheels but does bring DAB radio, a lane departure warning system, cruise control, and Bluetooth hands-free connectivity. You only get electric front windows, too. The rears are wound manually. Feel brings alloys and aircon, plus a contrast roof color, electric windows all round and Citroën's 7-inch touchscreen. Flair adds leather on the steering wheel and gear knob, an alarm, auto lights and wipers, rear parking sensors and a reversing camera. The C3 shares some family traits with its larger sister car, the C4 Cactus. In particular, it is available with that car's bubbled plastic strips along its flanks. Called air bumps, they're designed to offer protection in the sort of urban areas where cars typically pick up dings and dents, car parks, tight parking spaces and the like. They're not available at all on touch models, and are a cost option on feel, but the range-topping flare editions get them as standard. Other innovations include connected cam, which is a high-resolution camera mounted behind the rear-view mirror and focusing on the road ahead. It's constantly filming, and will save footage recorded at either side of any accident, but you can also use it to take pictures and share them on social networks via your mobile phone and a bespoke Citroën app. Citroën is basing its return to World Championship rallying on the C3, but the firm's managers admit they're struggling to work out how to balance the car's ethos, practicality and comfortable living, with a higher performance version that would harness some of the publicity from the motorsport program. Engines, performance, and drive. 3.5 star. Focuses on delivering comfort rather than thrills, and just about succeeds. Higher-powered petrols are pretty strong. Citroën has made great play out of the fact that the C3 is not focused on handling agility or out-and-out performance. As part of the brand's advanced comfort mantra, the C3 is trying to be an accomplished, refined companion that gets you from A to B with little fuss and no nasty interruptions from pockmarked road surfaces. In the most part, it succeeds. In the majority of conditions, the C3's suspension has enough compliance to soak up undulations and bumps and, while the trade-off for this is some body roll in corners, it never really becomes tiresome. The package can't quite shake off its relatively elderly underpinnings, though, just occasionally, you'll notice that sharp imperfections, particularly bad potholes or bridge expansion joints, mainly, will bump through to the cabin. Nor, it must be said, is there any real involvement to enjoy here. True to the brief, the steering is accurate and reasonably linear, but there's a little bit too much play around the straight ahead and at no point do you get a really good line of communication through from the front wheels. The likes of the Ford Fiesta and even the Skoda Fabia are on a different level when it comes to feedback. The three-cylinder petrol engines are decent enough, although you're likely to want to stick to the two more potent versions, badged PureTech 82 and PureTech 110, if you want to go anywhere in a hurry, because the entry-level 6.7 bhp unit will require regular encouragement. This, in turn, is also likely to have an impact on refinement, because while the petrols are quiet and smooth enough when they're cruising along, they can't escape a bit of three-cylinder thrum when they're being revved hard. We've yet to try the Blue Audi diesel, although we know this motor from other vehicles and like its character. Indeed, with its extra torque allowing you to waft around on low revs, this could be the unit most in keeping with advanced comfort. At its heart, the standard 5-speed transmission is slick enough, but it's not helped by a typical Peugeot Citroën linkage, an extremely long throw and a gear stick that has lots of play in it. At least the automatic option is an improvement, instead of the previous C3's dreadful automated manual, there's a reasonably smart and quick-shifting 6-speed torque converter automatic. Engines. Citroën has kept things pretty simple with the C3's engine lineup. There are basically just two motors, each of them offered in a few states of tune. The core petrol engine is a 1.2-liter three-cylinder unit. In entry-level form it produces 6.7 bhp and 106 Nm of torque, figures that are right down there with the most meager of Super Mini offerings. The same motor is available in two more respectable guises. There's an 81 bhp/118 Nm version, badged PureTech 82, and at the top of the range, a unit that gets turbocharged for 109 bhp and, more significantly, almost double the torque, at 205 Nm. The 81 bhp version is the only petrol engine available across all trim levels. The turbocharged motor can't be ordered with entry-level touch, while the 6.7 bhp unit isn't offered with range-topping flare. Sales of diesel superminis are actually pretty poor these days, but Citroën does have a 1.6-liter motor in the range. In its more modest form, it produces just 74 bhp but a useful amount of torque, at 233 Nm, so it's actually roughly equivalent to the mid-range petrol on acceleration figures and may well be quicker in real-world driving. There's also a 99 bhp version, which has even more low-end oomph, at 254 Nm. We'll have to wait to sample the diesels, but we have tried both the 81 bhp and 109 bhp petrols. The more potent unit is a more accomplished performer, for sure, happier with being asked to maintain swift progress along anything other than a motorway. However, the 81 bhp motor does have enough pep for most situations, just be prepared to sacrifice a little refinement to get there, because you'll encounter a three-cylinder thrum as you work it hard. We haven't had a chance to try the 67 bhp unit, but based on our experience of the mid-range motor, this is really going to be an option only if you have no other way into a C3. MPG, CO2 and running costs. 4 star. Three-cylinder petrols are pretty miserly on fuel, Blue Ahdi diesels offer some impressively low CO2 figures. Citroën has a decent record on fuel efficiency from its small petrol and diesel engines, and the C3 continues that trend. Every edition of the car, from the entry-level model on 15-inch wheels up to the range topper on 17s, emits less than 110 g/km of CO2, and all of the diesels are below 100 g/km. The cleanest C3 of all is the 1.6-liter Blue Ahdi in 109 bhp trim, which emits 92 g/km of CO2 when on 15-inch wheels and 93 g/km if you step up to 16-inchers. Those figures translate to combined fuel economy of 80.7 mpg and 78.5 mpg, so even if you're 20% or off Indiana the real world, you should still be able to nudge 55 mpg. The 99 bhp diesel isn't far behind, incidentally, at 95 g/km and 76.3 mpg. The core of the C3's lineup is petrol engines, though, and the 1.2-liter three-cylinder unit does a pretty decent job of maximizing fuel economy. The entry-level PureTech 68 returns 108 g/km of CO2 emissions and a claimed 60.1 mpg in the most basic trim level, touch, and 109 g/km and the same combined economy figure if you move up to feel and the 16-inch wheels that it brings. The mid-spec model, badged PureTech 82, matches its less powerful stablemates figures, though, including the slight variance depending on wheel size. And the range-topping turbocharged motor is the cleanest petrol of all, with CO2 emissions of 103 g/km and claimed fuel economy of 61.4 mpg, these are pretty reasonable figures, considering this engine is available on trim levels with 16 and 17-inch wheels only. It's helped by start/stop, a feature that isn't offered on the PureTech 68 or 82. Both diesels get it, however. In theory, then, the PureTech 110's 45-liter fuel tank gives a range just north of 600 miles, although in the real world, it's probably better to just say you'll be able to travel around 400 miles before you need to start worrying about a filling station. The diesel's range is more impressive again, of course, at as much as 800 miles, so you should be able to travel for 500 without worrying about refueling. These efficiency figures mean that until April 2017, a C3 will cost you either nothing at all, diesels, or 40 pounds, petrols, in vehicle excise duty, and that after that date, you'll face an annual VED bill of either 100 pounds, diesels, or 120 pounds, petrols. Insurance groups. The most basic C3, the PureTech 68, slots into insurance group 8E in both touch and feel trims, that's higher than the likes of Vauxhall's least powerful Corsa, but still pretty reasonable. Step up to the PureTech 82 and the group jumps to 10E, while the Blue Ahdi 75 and PureTech 110 both sit in group 16E. The most expensive C3S to insure will be the Blue Ahdi 100, it's in group 20E in both feel and flare trim levels. Depreciation. There's no data on the C3's residual values just yet. However, we'd expect it to perform more strongly than the outgoing edition, which was one of the most heavily discounted cars in UK showrooms. The extra scope for personalization could help here too, although it's worth pointing out that this also brings the potential for very individual versions that appeal to only a few customers. There could also be a variation in residual value depending on long-term demand for C3s with air bumps. Much will depend on how Citroën approaches the C3s prices and allows or encourages dealers to reduce them in negotiations. The company's management has expressed a desire to get away from heavy discounting, only time will tell if this can be translated through to the showrooms. Interior, design, and technology. 4.3 star. Some neat practical touches and a funky design make the C3's cabin stand out from the class average. The exterior of the C3 combines lots of Citroën's recent design traits into a pretty funky looking package. The front end is dominated by the ultra-slim daytime running lights and a huge double chevron badge, plus the larger headlights and fog lights mounted lower down. The flanks can either look pretty ordinary if you don't choose Citroën's air bumps textured protective plastic inserts, or quite different from the class norm if you do. And at the rear, there's a floating roof effect created by blacked-out C-pillars. The overall effect is a modern and stylish, and, perhaps most importantly, different from the likes of the conservative VW Polo, Skoda Fabia, and Hyundai i20. Don't climb into the C3 expecting it to be the last word in luxury, but Citroën has tried to follow up the external looks by creating a welcoming cabin that offers something different in the class. As such, the seats are similar to those found in the C4 Cactus, in that they're designed to be quite soft instead of offering supreme lateral support during cornering. The dashboard is very simple and, on all but the most basic trim level, dominated by a 7-inch touchscreen that controls many of the functions, including infotainment, heating, and aircon. There are some soft touch materials around the fascia, but the main plastics, those on top of the dashboard and those in the door linings, are hard, though nicely textured. The C3 just about manages to look smart and avoid feeling cheap, though the likes of the Skoda Fabia, VW Polo, and even the Renault Clio make a better fist of it. There are a few neat touches that help the C3 to stand apart, though. The main one is connected cam. An option on mid-spec feel and standard on range topping flare, it's basically a camera mounted at the back of the rear view mirror that constantly records what you're seeing out of the windscreen. In the event of an accident, it'll save the preceding 30 seconds and following 60 seconds of footage for use in any criminal proceedings or insurance claim. But you can also use it for more recreational activities, such as just taking pictures of anything you fancy as you drive along. The photos you take are then saved to your smartphone using the bespoke connected cam app and can then be shared on social networks. Citroën also reckons the C3 is the mainstream supermini with the greatest scope for personalization, and there's no denying that the extensive range of colors and options is impressive. You can have any of the 9 colors over the entire vehicle, or in combination with one of 3 contrast color roofs, giving a total of 36 possible exterior looks. There are a couple of different treatments of air bumps, too, further extending your ability to personalize your C3 if you order them. The entry-level C3s get 15-inch steel wheels with plastic covers, but all other editions get alloy wheels. These are 16-inch items on mid-spec feel and range-topping flare, although they can be upgraded further to 17-inch diamond-cut items. Sat nav, stereo and infotainment. Citroën was one of the first manufacturers to move to a fully integrated infotainment system that controls not only music and radio but also key vehicle functions, including heating and air conditioning. The C3 continues this trend, for while the entry-level model makes do with a relatively simple DAB radio system, feel and flare editions of the C3 get a 7-inch touchscreen mounted centrally and reasonably high up in the fascia. The system includes Bluetooth hands-free connectivity and media streaming, and there's also a USB socket and an auxiliary jack sited at the bottom of the dashboard, just ahead of the gear lever. Apple CarPlay is supported, along with Mirror Link, but there's no sign yet of Android Auto. It's worth noting that while the system is capable of navigation from the off, it's not actually activated unless you choose the software from the options list, only available on Feel and Flare editions. The system is reasonably sophisticated, and includes data on real-time traffic and fuel prices. It can be operated via the screen itself or through the use of voice commands. The C3S navigation isn't the friendliest on the market, but the overall system is easy enough to use. This is helped by permanent buttons at either side of the screen that allow you to jump straight to key features, navigation, heating, telephone, and so forth. It's just a pity that the setup doesn't have a slightly more powerful processor, because there's still a little too much lag between inputs and responses. You won't need to acclimatize to the system for very long before you'll be running a half step ahead of it on most complex instructions. Practicality, comfort, and boot space. 4-star. Decent boot for a modern super mini, but few other tricks to make the car stand out from the rest of the class. Citroën's advanced comfort mantra is as much about coping with the clutter of everyday life as it is ride quality, so it's a little disappointing that the C3 doesn't offer many standout tricks on the practicality front. That's not to say the C3 isn't capable. There's room in the cabin for 4 adults, just about, and the 300-liter boot is bordering on the generous for the class. But the relatively old platform below the C3 means that Citroën hasn't been able to incorporate any really neat tricks, such as a sliding rear seat that would allow you to prioritize either rear passenger legroom or boot space. What do you get? Well, there's a slightly random storage slot below the touchscreen in the dashboard, and bigger bin below it that could be handy for storing a phone when it's hooked up to the USB socket nearby. The door bins are a good size, it must be said, and their linings are painted white to help brighten the mood, and make it easier to find bits of clutter you've dumped there. There are seat back pockets on Feel and Flare editions, but basic touch spec does without them. The boot has a 60:40 split on all editions, but the aperture isn't the largest, thanks to the C3S funky tail lights. There's quite a lip to lift heavy items over, too, though at least there are a couple of lashing eyes to help you tie them down once they're in there. The C3 has quite an elevated feel, although it's still a super mini more than a baby SUV. This does give you quite a good view out, though, and the rear screen is deep enough to make reversing maneuvers relatively straightforward. Size. The days when a super mini had to be no more than 4 meters in length have long gone, but the C3 sticks close to this brief, another result, probably, of its older chassis components. Its 3,996 mm length and 1,829 mm width are shorter and wider than the Vauxhall Corsa or the Hyundai i20. The wheelbase is PAR for the Corsa 2, at 2,540. Or slightly longer than the VW Polos. Legroom, headroom and passenger space. It's possible for 4 adults to be reasonably comfortable in the C3, although the individuals who end up in the rear seats aren't going to be particularly happy if their companions up front are on the taller side. The biggest issue is knee and legroom, although the soft seat backs create a bit of leeway. Up front, there's no shortage of space for both occupants, and even if the optional panoramic roof is fitted, it's available on Feel and Flare only, 6-footers are unlikely to complain much about headroom. Getting in and out is straightforward too, thanks to doors that open to leave a pretty wide aperture, even for the rear seats. There's a pair of ISO fix points in the outermost rear seats, and the driver gets height adjustment on their seat on every edition of the C3. Boot. In raw terms, the C3S boot capacity is 300 liters, which is actually pretty decent when compared with the likes of the Ford Fiesta. It's enough for a decent-sized suitcase, although you'll need to pack cleverly if you're going to squeeze in overnight bags in there beside it. The shape is usefully square, but there's a fairly big lip at the rear bumper that you'll have to lift heavy items over before you can set them down into the load space. At least once they're there, you can use the lashing eyes in the boot to help tie them down and stop them sliding around. A split rear seat, 60:40, is standard across the range. You operate it using buttons near the headrests, but there are no fancy additional controls in the wall of the boot, like you get on some larger cars. With the seats folded right down, the C3S capacity grows to 900 liters. Reliability and safety. 3.8 star. Proven engines and well-known chassis parts should bring decent reliability. Plenty of safety kit and strong NCAP rating is predicted. The C3 doesn't scrimp on safety equipment. A lane departure warning system, speed sign recognition and speed warnings, a coffee brake alert and 3 ISOFIX mounting points, 2 in the rear, 1 in the front passenger seat, are standard across all models. In addition, Feel and Flare editions bring an alarm, and the top spec also gets connected cam, which constantly records video of the road ahead and saves up to 90 seconds of footage if it detects an accident. Flare also gets rear parking sensors and a reversing camera, and all models get the tire pressure monitor that's now part of the European safety regulations. Citroën hasn't had the car tested by the authorities yet, but the firm is confident the C3 will score a 5-star rating from safety experts Euro NCAP. This C3 is too new to have featured in our driver power reliability data, but it does use quite a few parts from the previous generation, which finished inside the top 70 in the most recent results. Citroën itself fared less well. It placed in the bottom half dozen manufacturers for customer satisfaction, just ahead of Ford but behind the likes of Alfa Romeo, Vauxhall, and Volkswagen. Warranty. There's nothing particularly special about Citroën's warranty. It lasts for 3 years or 60,000 miles, whichever comes soonest. This is just about standard for the industry, but some rivals, notably offerings from Kia and Hyundai, plus Toyota, offer much longer cover, at up to 7 years in Kia's case. Servicing. The servicing intervals on the C3 are as conventional as its warranty. It requires maintenance every year or 12,000 miles. Citroën has yet to confirm precise details on the costs involved, but it offers a couple of ways of spreading the bills. The first, more conventional method is a regular service plan, which covers the scheduled work over 3 years and is paid for by monthly direct debits. It can be arranged at any point during the car's first year. The second is a maintenance package that also includes wear on items, but this is considerably more expensive and has to be arranged on a dealer-by-dealer basis.